So we all know exercise is super healthy, right? It helps prevent a lot of diseases, it helps treat a lot of diseases, but is it more important than nutrition when it comes to health and when it comes to gains? Well, that's what we are going to look into today. Today we are going to look into the relationship between exercise, diet, health and gains, because, well, we want gains. But which one is more important? How can it impact our health? And which one should we worry the most about? Because let's be honest, a lot of people don't like to exercise, but can they still be super, super healthy just by controlling their diets? Or they really need to get the exercise? Or on the other side, if you don't really like to eat super, super, super healthy, or maybe just want to eat like 90% healthy, can you do exercise to combat the effects of the bad food that you have? That's everything that we are going to look into today. And first of all, let's start with the gains, because this is a really, really quick answer. Which one is more important to build muscle, lose fat? Is it the diet or the exercise? And the answer is, it depends. Because you can exercise as much as you want. If your diet is not somewhat good, you won't get any benefits. You might get some benefits if you're in a caloric surplus, you can still build muscle, or if you want to lose fat and you're in a caloric deficit, you'll still lose fat. That's like diet, diet, diet. That's why you see a lot of people with bad diets making gains, because calories are the most important thing. But you could get so much better results if you actually ate the right way and didn't just worry about the calories. So everything on the diet part is important. On the other side, you can eat as much protein as you'd like, you can have as many calories as you'd like. If you're not exercising, if you're not giving a reason for your body to build new muscle, then it simply won't and you'll just get fat. So there is no percentage for diet or exercise. Everything is important when it comes to gains, okay? Okay, and now for the important part, let's look into health and let's see what the science has to say about it. This 2010 report concluded that the lack of physical exercise is the sixth major risk factor for disease, whilst the first one was diet. And of course, there's a lot of stuff between the number one and six, like excess weight and all of that, that can be prevented with exercise, but you get the general idea that diet seems to be more important. And since we're at it, the biggest risk factor when it comes to diet is not eating enough fruit. From this study, walking 60 minutes a week can reduce mortality by 3%. 300 minutes per week can reduce your mortality by 14%, and walking 60 minutes a day can reduce your mortality by 24%. And I'm talking about walking, but any other activity will do. So as you can see, exercise is still pretty, pretty important and it can still make a huge difference in your health. That's why the recommendation for exercise is 60 minutes of intense activity or 90 minutes of moderate intensity. Okay, and now for the best part of the video, let's look into the impact of diet and exercise in our number one and number two killers: heart disease and cancers. So we know any type of exercise can help with blood flow and endothelial function, right? At the same time, we know that foods such as curcumin can help a bunch. As this study shows, curcumin and exercise is a great choice, and curcumin seems to be more effective than exercise. From this study, trying to reduce the resting heart rate of patients, 3 months of exercise was the equivalent of 190 grams of beans a day for 3 months. So you can either exercise for 3 months or eat beans. And this will help you reduce your resting heart rate, which has been associated with longevity and low heart disease. And now for an amazing landmark study. This study measured the arteries of the neck of vegans versus people on the standard American diet. What they found, no surprise, vegans had way better artery health. No surprise there, because the standard American diet group was overweight and everything. So what we need is a group of people that has the same BMI as the vegans, but still follows a standard American diet. So we can compare the standard American diet of people really exercise with vegans who don't do any exercise. This was the goal of this study, and that's why they looked into the arteries of marathon runners. People run like 2 marathons a week during several years. The result was pretty shocking. Even though the marathon runners have better artery health than the standard American dieters, the artery health of the vegans who didn't exercise was actually better than those who ran 2 marathons per week. So as you can see, when it comes to heart health, diet is the most important thing. And they took vegan diets, and I'm talking about vegan diets because it's the only diet, I mean, veganism is not a diet, as you know. A whole foods, plant-based, low-fat diet is the only diet scientifically proven to reverse heart disease, so that's why I'm talking about it. From this study on low-carb paleo diet, you can cancel the benefits of exercise when it comes to cholesterol with your diet, with your low-carb paleo diet. Okay, and now let's talk about cancer. In this study, exercise and a healthy plant-based diet shown to be incredible when it comes to fighting cancer. Nothing new here, we know eating veggies is good, and we know that exercising is good. But was it the diet or the exercise? This study took 3 groups. The first one, the control group, did nothing. The second group, a plant-based diet with moderate exercise. And the third group, only intense exercise with the standard American diet. What they did after was drip the blood of the patients in a petri dish full of cancer cells and see what happened. And these were the results. The blood of the first group on the traditional American diet with no exercise had pretty much no effect on cancer cells. The second group with a plant-based diet and moderate exercise had amazing results. And the third group with intense exercise and the traditional American diet had this. As you can see, exercise is great, but what's even better is a plant-based diet, a really healthy diet. You can get double the benefit. And the reason for this might be, as I've talked in previous videos, IGF-1, insulin-like growth factor 1, which is a growth hormone that helps cancer cells grow, and we do want some IGF-1 in our system, especially when we are growing up, because, well, we want to grow, but as we get older, we don't want that much IGF-1 in our blood, and animal protein has been shown to increase IGF-1 and therefore increasing cancer. That's one of the reasons why animal protein is associated with cancer growth and cancer rates. I really advise you to look more into IGF-1, animal protein and plant-based diets, but that's not the topic of this video. If you want me to talk about it, let me know down below. But I'm just gonna give you this study from Dean Ornish on prostate cancer, and it showed that vegan blood was 7 to 8 times stronger in fighting cancer cells. So as you can see, which one is more important, diet or exercise? Well, they're both really important. I really advise you to do both if you want to be healthy, if you want to live a long life. But as you can see, diet seems to be a little bit more important. But again, if this was a scale from 0 to 150, maybe diet would be 100 points and exercise 50 points or something like that. So it's still a pretty relevant number for exercise. That's why you really should do both and get off your couch. So that's it for the video, guys. Hopefully you enjoyed it. I'm really trying to bring the channel back right now, and my English is probably super, super rusty, but I'll keep working on it, and I'm gonna try to bring one video a week, so it will at least one video a week, and it will get better over time. So hopefully you stayed with me. Let me know in the comments down below, as always, what you thought of the video, and if my accent actually bothers you or not. And I'm gonna be seeing you all in the next video.